All right, moving on to this viral video. It's from a protest in Portland on Wednesday. So this is so interesting. Two federal agents, we don't know where they're from, who they're with, in full-on camo gear, no insignia, go to arrest a protester. They say nothing, no idea what this person has done. They don't say you're under arrest for this. Then they load him, or them, excuse me, I'm not sure, into an unmarked van. So what are they doing there? Our sister station in Portland reports that federal agents are deployed to protect federal property. They've made about a dozen arrests, but one person was seriously injured when a U.S. Marshal opened fire with less than lethal ammunition over the weekend. Meantime, after nearly 2 months of protests over the police-involved deaths of George Floyd, Ahmaud Arbery, Breonna Taylor, and more, where do things stand now, now that the media has largely turned its attention away? Lindsay, I just want to quickly talk on the protests in Portland. That's fascism from what I see. When you don't know who's taking you in, what you did wrong, there's no one to report to. That is the opposite of a republic. What do you think?
Right, and we don't want to see that type of outcome, but when we talk about protests now and the overall impact, I think that it's important to note that we want to overall reform of the entire system, right? There's systemic racism and things that are embedded in our system that are keeping people down. But many things have happened, and I have a whole list of things that have happened. Like officials in Washington, D.C., and California and Nevada have banned chokeholds. Mayor Bill de Blasio pledged to move funding from the police department to youth programs and mental health programs. You know, we got arrests in Ahmaud Arbery's case. We have arrests in George Floyd's case. We're still waiting for an arrest in Breonna Taylor's case. But many small things have happened, and we all know that change happens brick by brick. So when people think that we're not talking about these protests, maybe not on a national scale on the same level, but I think that many people are still in the streets and change is happening on a small level, and hopefully it'll keep just going up and up over time.
I agree with
you.
Because
all we have to focus on is this, and we're in the middle of a pandemic and there's nothing else to do. No one else is going outside besides to protest. So I think we are making major steps.
I do see progress. When we started talking about disbanding police because of systemic racism, that's something that's a very niche thing to talk about, and now it's in the general population. Erica, talk to me. Breonna Taylor, talk to me about that.
You know, I think, first of all, Monday, and Lindsay and I have on Instagram, you can see Who Cares What We Think, and we talk about Breonna Taylor and Sandra Bland. There's action steps still for Breonna Taylor. Callforbreonna.com, and you can call Kentucky lawmakers and make sure that they understand that you want justice for Breonna, as well as arrest the cops who killed Breonna Taylor. I think what has happened is we've gone from a very optical response where you could see people posting the black squares, you could see people saying Black Lives Matter, and now we're going into corporate response where how do we create change within our systems? We're going into the private sector. How do we create change within our systems? And I think that the non-optical response is non-optical because you don't see it immediately. But is change happening? Absolutely. But we need to keep Black Lives Matter, as well as justice for all of these people who haven't received it, very much on the front lines. And that's why the protesters are still in the streets.
I agree. It's maybe not so sexy, those little things like the corporate, what you're saying about, but they're just as important. But please go to those websites if you're interested.